When you hear a show tune from the great white way, does a shiver run through ya? Well, we're giving them to ya. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street. You
It's a city of strangers. Some come to work, some to play. A city of strangers. Some come to stare, some to stay. And every day, the ones who stay can find each other in the crowded streets and the guarded parks, by the rusty fountains and the dusty trees with the battered barks. And they walk together past the postered walls with the crude remorse. Friends of friends who they never know. Will you pick me up or do I meet you there? Shall we let it go? Did you get my message? 'Cause I looked in vain. Can we see each other Tuesday if it doesn't rain? Cook will call you in the morning or my service lunch plane. And another 100 people just got off of the train. It's a city of strangers. Some come to work, some to play. And another 100 people just got off of the train. And another 100 people just got off of the train. And another 100 people just got off of the train. Another 100 people just got off of the train.
And on March 28th, 1971, several hundred people got out of the subway or out of their taxi cabs or out of their limousines and walked through the doors of the Palace Theater to attend the 25th anniversary of the Tony Awards. Hello, this is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street here on 88.3 WLIW-FM, Long Island's only signature, one-of-a-kind, individual, idiosyncratic NPR station. Now, every late May for the last, I don't know, 5 or 6 years, we've looked at the Tony Awards 50 years ago. And this is a complicated year, obviously, because the current Tony Awards have been postponed, but there's no reason we can't go back into the past and see what life was like on Broadway half a century ago. Well, the 25th anniversary of the Tony Awards had a magnificent broadcast. I remember seeing it. Maybe some of our viewers, listeners out there viewed it. It brought back almost every star who had ever won a Tony Award. Alfred Drake and David Wayne and Gwen Verdon and Nanette Fabre, Zira Mostel, you name it. It was quite a spectacular evening. But the shows themselves that were nominated were also quite interesting and fascinating in their own way, in some odd ways, but we'll do a hop and a skip and a jump over them. You heard the voice of Pam Myers from Company, which definitely was the big winner in 1971. And she was nominated for Best Supporting Actress in a musical for Company. And Company was such an ensemble show that they carved up the supporting awards, I think, in very odd ways. But let us listen to another nominee for Best Featured Actress in a Musical, Barbara Barry. And this is a number that she shares with Charles Kimbrough, who was nominated for Best Featured Actor in a Musical, The Little Things You Do Together.
Harry.
Huh?
Do you want to stand there?
Okay. I'm standing here. Now what?
Darling, just come at me.
Okay.
Hey, you! What?
It's the little things you do together. Do together. Do together that make perfect relationships. The hobbies you pursue together, savings you accrue together, looks you misconstrue together that make marriage a joy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I could have blocked that.
No, that can't be blocked.
You want to do it again?
Okay.
I'll come at you again.
Okay.
It's the little things you share together, swear together, wear together, that make perfect relationships. The concerts you enjoy together, neighbors you annoy together, children you destroy together, that keep marriage intact. It's not so hard to be married when two maneuver as one. It's not so hard to be married, and Jesus Christ, is it fun. It's sharing little winks together, drinks together, kinks together, that make marriage a joy. The bargains that you shop together, cigarettes you stop together, clothing that you swap together, that make perfect relationships.
Oh, oh,
Uncle?
Uncle, your ass!
It's not talk of dawn and the decade ahead that allows you to get through the worst. It's I do and you don't, and nobody said that, and who brought the subject up first? It's the little things, the little ways you cry together, lie together, that make perfect relationships. Becoming a cliche together, growing old and great together,
withering away together,
that makes marriage a joy.
It's not so hard to be married.
It's much the simplest of crimes.
It's not so hard to be married.
I've done it 3 or 4 times.
It's people that you hate together,
hate together, date together,
that make marriage a joy.
It's things like using force together, shouting till you're hoarse together,
getting a divorce together,
that make perfect relationships. Uh-huh. Kiss, kiss.
Mm-hmm. Where are you going?
She's going to visit her grandmother in Trenton, New Jersey.
No, 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 no.
And that was from No, No, Nanette, obviously, one of the major nominated field shows, a big, big popular hit, revival of a musical from the 20s. And that one line you heard, she's going to visit her grandmother in Trenton, was the winner of Best Featured Actress in a Musical. That's Patsy Kelly, who had a long and storied career in Hollywood in the 20s and 30s and 40s. And I think that's the only thing on the cast album that I can play of her. She had one line. So maybe that's a record, how few words you could get on a cast album and still win a Tony Award. Well, let us go to Best Featured Actor in a Musical. That field was pretty slim. There were only three nominees: Charles Kimbrough, who you heard a little bit of in the cut from Company before, and this is Walter Willison, who was singing a song written by Richard Rodgers and Marty Sharnan from 2x2, I Do Not Know a Day I Did Not Love You.
I do not know a day I did not love you. I can't remember love not being there. The planting when the earth ran through your fingers. The harvest when the sun danced in your hair. I do not know a day I did not need you, for sharing every moment that I spent. I needed you before I ever. Before I knew what needing someone meant. And if we ever were to have tomorrow, one fact alone is full and filled with song. You will not know a day I do not love you the way that I have loved you all along. And if we ever were to have tomorrow, one fact alone is full and filled with song. You will not know a day I do not love you the way that I have loved you.
Pampered faces, regard the costly clothes, every carefree figure in a courtly pose. Sniff the fragrant powder and smell the scented oil. Note the slender fingers that have not known toil. A world of pleasure and privilege, elegant, elite, a private Arcadia. Well, life is sweet. Beautiful and polished, exclusive and elect, wary of outsiders as you might suspect. See the couples dancing to flute and violin. Aren't you rather jealous that you can't come in? A world of pleasure and privilege, elegant, elite, a private Arcadia. Well, I see. This gay and gilded sphere, how much would you pay to be included here? Make your highest offer, but bear this thought in mind: your bid may be rejected if you're not our kind. A world of pleasure and privilege, elegant, elite, a private Arcadia. Well,
and you just heard the winner for Best Featured Actor in a Musical. That was Keen Curtis, who played four very different roles in Bach and Harnack's final musical that they ever wrote together of any significance, The Rothschilds. And he had an interesting arc, because he played pretty much all the arch enemies of authority of the Jewish family, the Rothschilds. And that was the number that opened the show, a rather genius number of, I think, a wonderful score by Bach and Harnack, King Curtis there. Well, let us go in our look here at the 1971 Tony Awards to Best Actor in a Musical. And again, it was such a strange season. There weren't that many, you know, shows that were nominated. A lot of people in some of those shows. Here is an utter rarity. Here is the first and I think only time a replacement was nominated for a Tony. This is Larry Kurt playing the role of Bobby in Company. He took over for Dean Jones a couple of weeks after Dean Jones opened in it. And it's really kind of a miracle, and we have to thank Thomas Z. Shepard, the record producer of Columbia, for re-recording Larry Kurt and dubbing him into a cast album of Company that was released in London, where he played it. But be that as it may, we have a chance to hear Larry Kurt, one of the nominees for Best Actor in a Musical, 1971.
Someone to hold you too close, someone to hurt you too deep, someone to sit in your chair to ruin your sleep.
That's true, but there's more than that.
Is that all you think there is to it?
You've got so many reasons for not being with someone, but Robert, you haven't one good reason for being alone.
Come on, you're onto something, Bobby. You're onto something.
Someone to need you too much. Someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short, to put you through hell.
You see what you look for, you know.
You're not a kid anymore, Robbie. I don't think you'll ever be a kid again, kiddo.
Hey, buddy, don't be afraid that it won't be perfect. The only thing to be afraid of really is that it won't be.
Don't stop now. Keep going.
Someone you have to let in. Someone whose feelings you spare. Someone who, like it or not, will want you to share a little, a lot.
And what does all that mean?
Robert, how do you know so much about it when you've never been there?
It's much better living it than looking at it, Robert.
Add him up, Bobby, add him up.
Someone to crowd you with love. Someone to force you to care. Someone to make you come through, who'll always be there, as frightened as you of being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive.
Blow out the candles, Robert, and make a wish. Want something. Want something.
Somebody hold me too close. Somebody hurt me too deep. Somebody sit in my chair and ruin my sleep and make me aware of being alive. Somebody need me too much. Somebody know me too well. Somebody pull me up short and put me through hell and give me support for being alive. Make me alive. Care. somebody make me come through. I'll always be there, as frightened as you, to help us survive being alive. Being alive. Being alive.
Operator! Operator! Hello, hello, telephone girlie, please tell my wife I'm here. Hello, hello, do I hear you, Lucille? Please come over, dear. Wifey, darling, please don't hang up again. All alone, I don't want to sup again. Now you've wrecked it, she's disconnected.
Never fear,
we are here.
You're a silly little billy.
You forget the evening hasn't started yet.
When little wifey hangs up, remember there are other names in the book. Some little number whose cup will cheer you if you take the trouble to look. While the hour's early, call some girlie, lift that old receiver off the hook. Get busy.
When little wifey hangs up,
remember there are other names in the book.
Who'd be more adorable than Flora on a date?
You know who'd be good, little Winnie would.
Little Winnie would be good, but Betty would be great.
I am free for a spree.
I am too.
What say you?
Flora, Betty, Winnie, and there's also Madcap May, Fascinating Faye, Cute and Cuddly Kay, Ella, Della, Stella, Isabella, Sue, and that's to mention just a few. When little wifey hangs up, remember there are other names in the book. Some little number whose cup will cheer you if you take the trouble to look. While the hour's early, call some girlie, lift that old receiver off the hook. Get busy.
When little wifey hangs up,
remember there are other names in the
other names in the other names in the book.
Bobby Vann, nominee for leading actor in a musical, 1971, a real star turn for him in No, No, Nanette, bringing his particular brand of song and dance back to Broadway. Well, the winner for best actor in a musical was a guy who had toiled on Broadway for a long time. He was, quote unquote, everybody's understudy, and he had a starring role in the Rothschilds, as Meyer Rothschild, in just the most charming, humane, embracing performances. So a much-deserved Tony for Hal Linden singing In My Own Lifetime.
In my own lifetime I want to see the fighting cease. In my own lifetime, I want to see my sons enjoy the fruits of peace. While I'm still here, I want to know, beyond a doubt, that no one can lock us in or lock us out. We have climbed higher, much higher than I thought we'd climb. It's a long journey, and even though the end's in sight, there's not much time. I want to know, we haven't built on sand. In my own lifetime, in my own life, I want to see our efforts blessed. In my own lifetime, I want to see the walls come down, and then I'll rest. This Moses wants to see the promised land in my own lifetime.
That was Hal Linden's Tony-winning Turn from the Rothschilds. I mean, the Tonys are still rather miraculous in that way. It certainly led to opening a lot of doors for Hal Linden. And very soon after that, of course, he played Barney Miller on television. So there you go. Let us turn to Best Actress in a Musical. I'm going to play a cut that, you know, if I had my druthers, I wouldn't play, because it's tough going, in my opinion. This is Sandy Duncan from a revival of The Boyfriend, the Sandy Wilson musical. It's not great art, but we want to be historic here and archival. So here is one of the nominees, Sandy Duncan, for Best Actress in a Musical.
What a lovely day, what a lovely day for a dip in the sea. Oh, what fun it will be. Won't you come and have a swim with me?
But whatever you do when I'm swimming with you, please remember not to go too far.
For you may look cute in your bathing suit, we don't know who you are. There's no knowing who you are going to meet, Sir Raja.
You may run up against a Raja,
or maybe your man
will be a poor man.
Sam or Susie cannot be choosy, for now love's a guessing game.
Well, as I said earlier in the broadcast, the 1971 Tony Awards were kind of odd the way they decided who was in which category. Here are two magnificent performances from Company, the Stephen Sondheim, Hal Prince musical, George Firth musical, which swept the Tonys that year. Why they were Best Actress rather than Featured Actress, I've no idea. But here is Susan Browning and Dean Jones certainly giving a performance of a lifetime. She also had a huge monologue in it, so maybe that's what bumped her upstairs a little bit. At any rate, Susan Browning from Company.
Where you going?
Barcelona.
Oh.
Don't get up.
Do you have to?
Yes, I have to.
Oh.
Don't get up. No, you're angry.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not. Put your things down.
See, you're angry.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not. Put your wings down and stay.
I'm leaving.
Why?
To go to.
Stay.
Fly,
I know, to Barcelona. Look, you're a very special girl, not just overnight.
know you're a very special girl. Not because you're bright, not just because you're bright. You're just a very special girl, June.
April, thank you.
What you thinking?
Barcelona.
Oh.
Flight 18.
Stay a minute.
I would like to.
So.
Don't be mean.
Stay a minute.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Where you going?
Barcelona.
So you said.
And Madrid.
Bon voyage.
On a Boeing.
Good night.
You're angry.
No.
I've got to.
Right.
Report to.
Go.
That's not to say. That if I had my way. Oh, well, I guess.
What?
I'll stay.
But. Oh,
I'd like to propose a toast. Here's to the ladies who lunch. Everybody laugh. Lounging in their caftans and planning a brunch. On their own behalf. Off to the gym, then to a fitting, claiming their fat. And looking grim, 'cause they've been sitting, choosing a hat. Does anyone still wear a hat? I'll drink to that. Here's to the girls who stay smart. Aren't they a gas? Rushing to their classes in optical art, wishing it would pass. Another long, exhausting day. Another $1,000. A matinee, a pinter play. Perhaps a piece of Mahler's. I'll drink to that. And one for Mahler. Here's to the girls who play wife. Aren't they too much? Keeping house but clutching a copy of Life just to keep in touch. The ones who follow the rules and meet themselves at the schools, too busy to know that they're fools. Aren't they a gem? I'll drink to them. Let's go! Girls who just watch
aren't they the best? When they get depressed, it's a bottle of scotch plus a little jest. Another chance to disapprove, another brilliant singer, another reason not to move, another vodka singer. I'll drink to that. So here's to the girls on the go. Everybody tries. Look into their eyes and you'll see what they know. Everybody dies. A toast to that invincible bunch. The dinosaur surviving the crunch. Let's hear it for the ladies who lunch. Everybody rise. 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 Rise.
Well, you all know that performance. That, of course, is Elaine Stritch as Joanne singing The Ladies Who Lunch from Company. And many of you will know that as well from the incredible crisis she had in recording that number for the cast album. She wound up staying till, you know, three in the morning and didn't get it, went back the next day. If you saw that wonderful documentary, and it's a good moment to give a shout out, another shout out to Thomas Shepard, who was the producer of four of our albums today, The Rothschilds, No, No, Nanette, 2x2, and Company. Well, Elaine Stritch didn't win that one. It went to a woman who actually preceded her on Broadway, an actress who made her debut in 1944. Stritch made hers in 1946 and had been around for a very long time, putting in her dues and then some. And that was Helen Gallagher, who finally got the Tony for her performance in No, No, Nanette. So here is that award-winning performance, Too Many Rings Around Rosie.
When December seemed like May, ring around the rosy with the boys I used to play. Tommy, Andy, Harold, Joe ate my candy, then would go. I tried to please them all, you know. That's why not one became my beau. Too many rings around Rosie, we'll never get Rosie a ring. Too many bows when she should have one. You know we'll never bring her a ring around her finger. One little name to remember is better than having a string. It doesn't hurt to flirt a bit, but use it. Make your match, make your catch before it's too late. 'Cause too many rings around Rosie, we'll never get Rosie a ring. Men are only grown-up boys, pretty ladies are their toys. Here today, tomorrow they're in search of other joys. It is nice to have a few all go loco over you. Still, one ring to call your own is worth a half a dozen on the phone. Oh, too many rings around Rosie. We'll never get Rosie a ring. Too many bows when she should have one. You know we'll never bring her a ring around her finger. There may be safety in numbers when you are out on a fling.
many foes when she should have one. You know we'll never bring her a ring around her finger. One little name to remember is better than having a string.
Oh, it's low these many years since marriage began. Even then, what were men compared to a man? Oh, too many rings around Rosie. We'll never get Rosie.
Poor little Rosie.
Never get Rosie a ring.
Never get Rosie a
ring. This is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street here on WLIW-FM. And we're supported in our endeavors, in part, by the Ira and Leonora Gershwin Philanthropic Fund. Well, one of the odder things about the 1971 Tonys is that there were only three nominees for Best Musical. It was a bit of a fait accompli, I think. But here is a charming show called The Me Nobody Knows. It originated off-Broadway and moved to Broadway during the season and was based on a series of poems and letters by kids from the inner city. So here is a number from that show. It holds up pretty well today, I think, somewhat sadly, but still pertinent today. The Me Nobody Knows.
It's getting nearer, nearer every day. every head held high, for at last we're underway. Founders of the famous financial firm Rothschild and Sons.
Jaws will drop when the world finds out what a step we took today.
Copenhagen's favorite banking house, Rothschild
and Sons. Yes, you skeptical souls who sold us short.
We're superior agents of the court.
Twinkling high in the fiscal sky is a newly risen star.
There's another firm in the firmament,
Rothschild
and Sons.
Stands ready to satisfy an expanding clientele.
Servants of a prince and a king so far, Rothschild
and Sons. Who's at home in the gilded halls where the reigning blue bloods dwell? Members of a firm whose initials are Rothschild and Sons.
We're superior agents of the court. International finance is our fort.
Say hello to a bright new world, to a bleak one say farewell.
Look who's making loans to the Danish crowd. Look who gave a shove and a wolf came down. Look who's making loans,
gave a shove and a
Rothschild
and Sons.
Well, if you hadn't guessed, that number was from the Rothschilds, our second of three nominees for Best Musical 1971. And the winner, you've already guessed it, because it's one of the greatest musicals of all time, completely changed the way we thought about musicals and set the tone for the rest of the decade and beyond. Company, score by Stephen Sondheim, book by George Firth, direction by Harold Prince. It was nominated for 14 Tonys and won 6. Pretty darn good. So here is our big winner from 1971, 50 years ago, a show that endures. Hopefully we'll see it again in its third Broadway revival, I think, in the upcoming season 2B. At any rate, here is Company.
Company. No strings, good times, room hums, company. Late nights, quick bites, party games, deep talks, long walks, telephone calls. Thoughts shared, souls bared, private names, all those photos up on the walls. With love, with love. my friends. Those good and crazy people, my married friends. And that's what it's all about, isn't it? That's what it's really about. Really about.
Bobby, baby.
Robbie, darling.
Name it Sarah.
Bobby, listen, pal, I'd like your opinion.
Why me, Peter?
Bobby,
I need your advice. Can I call you back tomorrow?
If you're busy, the kids want to talk.
Ginny, I could take them to the
zoo. Bobby,
you know, where have you been?
Time all gone to. This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more.